Welcome to another edition of No BS Reactions. Super Dave here at Progwarts, and it's time to explore some new music. In this case, older music that's new to me. So, I started down the Cardiacs rabbit hole, and what I discovered along the way is a band that is truly unique in a, you know, Monty Python meets King Crimson meets Blondie kind of way, and that they have a very passionate and dedicated fan base. So today, I'm moving forward with my exploration of this really idiosyncratic band with a recommendation from viewer Schism65. This is a longer song by them, and I think I've listened to so far. As much as they fit into their shorter songs, I am really curious to see what happens in this one. So this song comes from their third demo album, The Seaside, released in 1984, I believe. If I'm wrong, someone will let me know in the comments, I'm sure. So this is Gibber and Twitch by Cardiacs on No BS Reactions. Buckle up. It's incredibly helpful to switch the view and all that stuff while I'm doing this. Pardon the faux pas.
Just for a moment. Look at me below. No wonder I'm feeling bored all the time. Could it be that I'm wrong? I'm not on the bed then again.
Oh, it would be nice for everyone. It would be nice for everyone. I want a lovely way to be. I want a lovely way to be. It would be nice for everyone. It would be nice for everyone. I want a lovely way to be. I want a lovely way to be.
Sit me down and make me stay to say the first things on my mind. My soldier will hate silver bells and cockle shells and I'll put it all in a row if my leg gets a part of me. I always knew what was wrong with me.
Okay. If you thought I was kidding with the description of Monty Python meets King Crimson meets Blondie, I was not. This is it in spades, plus a few other things. I wasn't sure what to expect. But again, these guys tend to, at times, feels like they've taken parts of other songs and Frankensteined them together. I don't know how they came up with these things as they put them together. Starting off, we hear, you know, little tinkling chimes kind of sound or whatever, and this ambient kind of hum. I don't know if that is what, an old Moog synthesizer? Or what that is, or whatever they call that, but honest to God, it reminded me of the early seconds or minutes of like La Villa Strangiato or Xanadu by Rush. You know, just so that's what makes it think it's the Moog, because I'm not mistaken, that's what Rush was using at the time, so it absolutely sounded like that. So it sets you up for an expectation of something that perhaps a little slower tempo, perhaps a little more melodic than these guys sometimes do. And then they punch you in the face and pull the rug out from under you. And they go, no, screw that. We're doing a lot of what we normally do, which next thing you know, it's almost like some sort of carnival music with phone sound effects or like phone ringing sound effects, like old phone ringing sound effects and such. And it gets silly, which is what they do. And then interestingly enough, segues into a rather hooky chorus. these guys. If you want something to entertain someone with very short attention span, them, they've got you covered. That is pretty much it. It's very, again, as always, entertaining, surprising. You never quite know what's coming. There is a certain kind of introspective philosophy, I think, in the lyrics. But at the moment, taking this all in at once, I am too slow to figure it out. So I'm not even going to offer something that's going to approach some sort of interpretation of what I am singing in the lyrics. Because, yes, they tend to sing quickly a lot of times and very choppy. If I didn't have the lyrics in front of me, I have no way I'm following. None at all. Well, maybe a little bit, maybe in the chorus, but let's back this up ever so slightly to start with the next verse. And here we go back again.
I always knew what was wrong with me. I could tell by my general attitude. I always knew it would get physical. I could tell from that longitude, latitude. Good Lord! Look at the cakes! I'm gonna go and
mix them all up.
Or is it that I'm dreaming? Look at my finger, my hinges just for a moment. Look at me, what am I feeling for all the time? Could it be that I'm wrong, I'm right, I'm wrong, but then again?
Oh, it would be nice for everyone. It would be nice for everyone. Oh, what a lovely way to be. Oh, what a lovely way to be. It would be nice for everyone.
To say the first things on my mind, my soldier will have silver bells and cockle shells and a free maid all in a row, yeah. Always knew what was wrong with me. I could tell by my general attitude.
Attitude.
I always knew it would get physical. As a part of my longitude, latitude.
It's the same, I sometimes wonder if something or other is in my head.
Well, sure. Why not? again, always entertaining. You're never quite sure what you're going to get with Cardiacs, and I think that's one of the things so many people admire about them. Not to mention the instrumental gymnastics that they are going through with the sudden time signature changes and the tempo changes. I'm not enough of a musician to know, but I have a feeling a lot of this cacophony, this chaos that goes on in these songs, as much as it's organized, it's probably got a lot more going on to it than is easily heard in the midst of it, because it's just coming at you so fast. There's so many, like a train of thought, a stream of consciousness kind of composition that I hear with their songs, where he's just kind of gone from one thing to another. In that song, it followed at least a somewhat more traditional verse, chorus, post-chorus, as it was labeled in the lyrics, verse, chorus, transition, verse, chorus, transition, which I think compared to one of the other songs, or one of both the other songs maybe I heard, where they almost went from portion to portion, and they weren't all necessarily obviously musically connected by the same ideas, almost as if, again, a pastiche of songs and genres into one thing that didn't circle back or repeat at all. This one followed a more traditional song format, but also, take note, historically, this is from one of their demos, their third demo. They're still working on getting a contract. I can see why in the early 80s, in many ways, it might have been difficult to obtain a record contract, because this is challenging, unusual, unique music. It does not lend itself to radio fodder. It does not lend itself to easy absorption on the first listen. And, you know, that's for me. Like I said, it's like I'm hearing so much going on, and then boom, 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 we're changing genres or styles or tempos or rhythms. And these lyrics are either just oblique in the terms of being silly, or there's something else beneath them that is going to require repeated readings to firmly grasp the train of thought that's behind them. I'm not sure which it is. Again, it's like there's this feeling that the songs on the surface present themselves as somebody being chaotic and silly. And perhaps at the same time, there's a lot more thought process going on underneath, especially when you compare and look to the influence that they have had on musicians down the road and the reverence that they have generated. So it's likely one of those things that is easily dismissible on the surface because it just seems goofy. And at the same time, you know what? Maybe it's got a lot of less obvious thought process going on. So these guys I do find fascinating in many ways. I don't know how much this is a band I would throw into a playlist and just let them pop up from time to time, but boy, I can imagine the crowds that would be at their concerts and exactly how they might be and how these shows could be one big party. That's what I picture it, is that it's just such a level of wackiness that it generates a party atmosphere. And that may be one of the things that has led people to love them as much as they have. So definitely worth exploring further. I want to keep seeing if at some point in time they hit on something that I just go, ooh, cool. I want to really just want to listen to that amongst all my other music, or whether I'll continue to see them as something of a musical curiosity that is triggering more of an intellectual response from me than it is an emotional response. We'll see. Definitely lots of intellectual stuff going on there. This is kind of like music nerd stuff, I think. Maybe. I don't know. Music nerds can let me know. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Let me know if you think I am not giving this band their due, or if perhaps I'm reading more into some of this stuff than is deserved. Or just tell me what you think of the band. Clearly, there's a lot of dedicated fans out there who really enjoy them, and I can see in many ways why. If this is prog rock, it is prog rock in a goofy, silly way that has punk elements to it that you don't hear in prog rock. So in that sense, they've carved out their own niche, and that may be, again, one of the things you guys love about them. So, you know, let me know what your thoughts are. And hey, if you want to give me more recommendations as I continue down what truly is rabbit hole, seems very descriptive here, because it does feel a little bit like it's got an Alice in Wonderland Tea Party feeling to it. So just throwing it out there. So anyway, if you drop some comments, that would be great. While you're doing that, if you could just hit a like and subscribe, that will be wonderful. Follow along in my adventures through the progosphere. You'll also find the social media links in the descriptions if you want to follow along out in that world as well. Don't forget, too, there's the link for my live 365 channel, The Expanse, nothing but prog rock and prog metal all the time. And on Sundays, we now have the Brain Salad Sunday, which features all classic prog from the 60s and 70s. So you can dig into all that goodness. Meanwhile, that's all I got for you. Remember, never fear to deviate from the norm like the Cardiacs. Keep it proggy. This is Super Dave, signing off.